Hello viewers, this is Balaji Badrinath again with you all with another one more video, and this time I am with my good friend Ram Shrikant, who is into the home loans. And today this is going to be just a trial of all the queries and questions which we have received from most of our clients with respect to the home loans. And viewers like you have been asking so many questions with respect to the home loans, and Ram Shrikant will try to answer those. The questions which he's answering today is going to be just a glimpse of it. So if you want more to be answered or more to be addressed when it comes to home loans or any other loans for that matter, like business loans, mortgage, commercial loans or whatever it is, please put in the comments. Let's begin the show today.
The trending home loan interest rate currently with Citibank is 6.75%, and with the Bank of Baroda it is 6.85%, with SBI it is 6.90%, and with HDFC Limited it is 6.95%. These are the four financial institutions which are good in the market in terms of processing, in terms of customer service and offering best rate. Yes, definitely. If you have any plans of buying a property and looking for a housing loan, this is the right time to invest in your real estate investment for personal use or for investment purpose also, as the rates have come down historically. 6.75% is the minimum rate that the banks are charging, as well as the real estate is also softened. Yes, it is beneficial to some extent, as the banks are offering women interest rate, which is 0.05% lesser than others rate. Once you submit all the documents in one single shot, that it will take only 7 working days to get a home loan sanction from any financial institution. If you are applying for a loan amount below 30 lakhs under the scheme of PMAY, then there is no processing fee. If you are applying for more than 30 lakhs loan amount, then a standard processing fee of 10,000 plus GST, which is 11,800, is charged. Yes, there is no need to property to be finalized for applying a housing loan. You can check your home loan eligibility by applying even before selecting the property. There are many ways to enhance your eligibility, like by adding your wife if she is working, by adding her to the home loan application you can enhance the eligibility, by declaring whatever additional incomes, consider you have some fixed deposits and you are getting some interest over those fixed deposits to your account, declaring that as your income in income tax returns. If you are receiving any rentals, if you are receiving any kind of returns through your investments, please do declare all those incomes in your returns and file it. With that you can definitely increase the eligibility. CIBIL score is mainly dependent on the type of accounts that you hold. More number of unsecured accounts is called risky profile. Consider you have more number of credit cards or more number of loans, like personal loans, then it affects your CIBIL score in a negative manner. So improving CIBIL score is reducing your unsecured accounts is the primary task that to be done. Reduce your number of cards, reduce number of personal loans that you have, then automatically your CIBIL score will improve depending on your repayment habit. Maximum eligibility depends again on your repaying plans. If you are planning to repay at the earliest, then yes, going for a maximum loan doesn't affect much. But if you have longer repayment periods of 30 years, then the interest component in the EMI is too high, which will make you will be paying double or more than double of the loan amount by the end of 30 years. So limit your loan amount to maximum to 70% or 75%, so that you can pay less in terms of repayment. Top 5 banks as per my choices, I'm just going with the service point of view. The first bank is HDFC in terms of service point of view, which are they are offering at 6.95%. Second is SBI, which is offering at 6.90%. Third is Citibank, they are offering at 6.75%. And fourth is BOB, they are offering at 6.85%. And the fifth is Axis Bank, who are offering at 6.80%. Before applying any housing loan, I would rather suggest you please cross-check with your CIBIL score, as all financial institutions have come up with CIBIL score which is directly affecting your rate of interest. More the CIBIL score, if your CIBIL score is more than 775, then you are eligible for best interest rates. Then it is called as a category 1 profile. If you have CIBIL score less than 775, it is called as a category 2 profile, where the rate of interest will be increased by 0.10%. So please take care of your CIBIL score and regularly have a watch on the CIBIL score, like now in your repayment habits. Please do keep a watch on the repayment habits so that the CIBIL score is well maintained. Yes, definitely. Banks will check whether you have opted for a moratorium or not. Once the moratorium is over, if you had paid 3 EMIs, completed 3 EMI payments, then yes, you are eligible for a loan again. For a home loan, no, it will not affect your eligibility.